Hello students, so we are discussing about the microorganisms, their uses and the harmfulness of the microorganisms in our day-to-day life. So now we reached the last concept of this lesson, that is the nitrogen cycle. So already we learnt about the nitrogen in the 7th standard. So it is present in about the 78% in the atmosphere. And it is a very essential constituent for all the living essentials. So here in the screen of your mobiles, you can see the nitrogen cycle. So how it is going to rotate, or how it is going to maintain its constant volume in the nature. So after the utilization of the organisms, the quantity of this nitrogen, it is remaining the same. So that is the 78% in the environment. So many organisms like plants, they are using the nitrogen as the essential constituent for their growth. So after using this nitrogen, so the amount of nitrogen which is present in 78% in the environment, that is remaining 78% only. So how it is going to be maintained a constant volume? So here let us study about the nitrogen cycle. So in the previous session already we learnt about the nitrogen fixation. So that is the bacteria called rhizobium is going to fix the nitrogen in the leguminous plants. So the rhizobium is the bacteria which is going to be live in the leguminous plants roots. So they will prepare the root noodles and they will be there only, like the beans and peas. So they are going to maintain the symbiotic relationship. So symbiotic relationship means the organisms which are depending on each other. So the one is depending on the other and the other is also depending on the first one. So like that only. So here we can see the importance of the nitrogen. So here the nitrogen is one of the essential nutrient for the living organisms in the form of the proteins, chlorophyll, nucleic acids, and also in the form of the nutrients, or in the form of the vitamins also. We can see the importance of this nitrogen. So in the atmosphere, it is not present in the soluble form. So the 78% of the nitrogen which is present in the atmosphere, so it should not be utilized by any of the organisms directly. So the nitrogen which is present in the insoluble form, that is utilized by some of the bacteria and some blue-green algae. Which are present in the soil, they will fix the nitrogen from the atmosphere. They will fix the nitrogen from the atmosphere into the compounds of the nitrogen. So the bacteria and some blue-green algae which are present in the soil, they will convert the insoluble form of this nitrogen into the soluble form, or into the usable form. So after converting this nitrogen which is in the insoluble form into the compounds of nitrogen, so the plants which are the considered as the producers, they will utilize the fixed or the compounds of nitrogen as the nutrients for their growth, and they will utilize and they will grow, and it will be there in the form of the nucleic acids, proteins, or it may be in the form of the chlorophyll. So here in the cyclic manner, we can see how the nitrogen is going to be present in the constant constant volume in the nature. So if you consider this atmospheric nitrogen, this is the atmospheric nitrogen that is present in the 78%. So 78% of this atmospheric nitrogen is present. So here by the lightning process, the nitrogen fixing, so here the atmospheric nitrogen is utilized by the some of the bacteria. So they will fix that nitrogen into the soluble form. So that bacteria in turn fix the nitrogen into the nitrogenous compounds. So the nitrogen which is present in the insoluble form in the atmosphere, and that will be converted into the compounds of nitrogen. So that will be converted into the compounds of nitrogen. So that compounds of nitrogen which is present in the soil, that is utilized by the plants, that is in the form of the nutrients. So that is in the form of nutrients, that is called the uptake by the plants in the form of compounds. So the nutrient which is present in the plants, which is taken by the plants, that will be eaten by the animals. So the green plants which are present in the form of the vegetables, fruits, seeds or other products of the green plants, so those are eaten by the animals. So here the animals, they will produce the nitrogenous waste products by the excretion and also by the death of the organism. Whatever the nitrogenous waste or the nitrogenous products produced by the animals, and they will convert into the wastage. So the animals will excrete, and after the death of the animals, whatever the nitrogenous products present in the animal, again they will join the soil, and again it will be utilized by the plants. So like this it will rotate here. So whatever the nitrogenous products, the nitrogenous compounds prepared by the bacteria, that are all not consumed by the plants. So some of those bacteria turns the compounds of nitrogen into gaseous nitrogen. So here the compounds of nitrogen are converted into the gaseous nitrogen by the some of the bacteria, and again it will reach the atmosphere. So here this is the one cycle, it is completed. So here when here the atmospheric nitrogen, so by the lightning, so itself by the sunlight, when the sunlight is going to be absorbed by the molecules of the nitrogen which is present in the atmosphere, itself it is going to convert into the compounds of the nitrogen. Again from that one, some quantity of the nitrogen compounds will be absorbed by the plants, and some are converted into the gaseous nitrogen products, and again it will reach the atmosphere. So whatever the form it is, either it is soluble form or insoluble form, so the nitrogen which is present in the nature, so it should be here only, it should be in the environment only. So that is called the the moment of the nitrogenous products. So here what you mean by nitrogen cycle means the moment of the nitrogenous products in the cyclic manner in the environment. So here we can see the atmospheric nitrogen, that is going to convert into the other forms, but it is nitrogen product only. So it is going to rotate in the environment in the cyclic manner. So that is why we consider this one as the nitrogen cycle. So cycle means it is rotating again and again, that is getting its original form. So again it is converting into the other forms, and same like that the clockwise and anticlockwise in the clockwise or anticlockwise, it will be utilized by the different organisms, it will be converted into the different forms, and again it is going to reach the same form. So this is called what? The nitrogen cycle. So you can hear in the textbook of 8th standard, you can see the page number 27, in that you can see the nitrogen cycle that you have to practice. So it is very important for the examination point of view. So you have to practice this nitrogen cycle. So if you have any doubts regarding this lesson, so here by this nitrogen cycle, this lesson is going to be complete. So in the so some questions are given in the back of this page, so you have to write the question answers. So if you get any doubts or difficulties or queries, you can send the questions through the WhatsApp number. Thank you for watching, and read carefully and seriously. Thank you.